Today we will see about extra ocular muscles. Extra ocular muscles. These are extraocular muscles are four recti, two oblique, one levator palp, one superioris, that is the levator palpebrae superioris. These are all voluntary muscles. These are all voluntary muscles and three are involuntary. Three are involuntary muscles. One is superior tarsal, inferior tarsal, then orbitalis. They are involuntary. Seven are voluntary, remaining three are involuntary muscles. Four recti muscles. Now we'll see what are the four recti muscles. Four recti muscles, they are superior rectus, inferior rectus, medial rectus, lateral rectus. Four rectus, their rectus are the small ribbon-like muscles. Small ribbon-like muscles, rectus means straight. Superior rectus, inferior rectus, medial rectus, lateral rectus. Then now comes two oblique muscle, that is the superior oblique. Inferior oblique. Then superior tarsal. Superior tarsal is regarded as part and parcel of the levator palpebrae superioris. It is also called Muller's muscle. It is a part and parcel of the levator palpebrae superioris. It is a voluntary, it is the involuntary. Inferior tarsal present between the inferior rectus and superior rectus, it is present. Orbitalis muscle is a bridge. Orbitalis muscle forms a bridge between the orbital fissure. It forms a bridge between the orbital fissure. The function is yet to be known. This superior tarsal is a part and parcel of the levator palpebrae superioris. It helps in elevation. Superior rectus help in elevation. Inferior rectus present in the depression of the eyeball. And it is present between the inferior rectus and superior rectus. Orbitalis is present, which bridges between the inferior fissure of the orbital fissure, it bridges. The function is uncertain. It is regarding the involuntary muscle. Involuntary muscle, I repeat, superior tarsal, which elevates the inferior tarsal, which depresses. Orbitalis, the function is uncertain. Now we will see in detail the volunteer muscles. The volunteer muscles. They are the rectus. I will tell right here, they are the four rectus. Rectus. Superior rectus, inferior rectus, then comes medial rectus, lateral rectus. They are the four muscles, and the two oblique, superior oblique, inferior oblique. One is levator palpebrae, levator palpebrae superioris. Superioris, these are the voluntary muscles, voluntary extraocular muscles, voluntary extraocular muscles. The peculiarities, what are the peculiarities is given to these muscles? This muscle have a motor unit, small motor unit, that ratio is one muscle fiber to the one nervous fiber to two muscle fiber, or three muscle fiber, or four muscle fiber. The ratio of the nerve fiber, one nerve fiber to two or three or four. Whereas other muscle fibers of the skeletal muscle is 1:125. The ratio of the nervous motor unit, one nerve fiber is equal to 2 to 3 or 4 muscle fibers. One nerve fiber, the ratio is 2 muscle fibers or 3 or 4 muscle fibers. But in other skeletal muscles of the body, one nerve fibers to 125 muscle fibers. One nerve fiber is equal to 125 in other skeletal muscles of the body. It is a peculiarity, one of the peculiarity of the body. It is the, it signifies the activity. It signifies the active movement of the rectus muscles. One significance. The other significance is, they are called as a yoke muscle. Yoke muscle. Yoke means it is the belt. Remember, seen the blocks, they are put on the both blocks are tied together. While plowing, you might have seen, while in the block cart, the both blocks are tied together. Yoke muscles, because the muscles of the both eye, acting together, muscles of the both eye functioning together to have the conjugatory movements. In the adduction, abduction, elevation, the both muscles of the eye are acting together. Hence, they are called as the yoke muscles. Yoke means the working together, tied together, functioning together is called as a yoke muscle. Yoke muscles, because to have a conjugatory movement, to have a normal movement of the eyeball, the both eye muscle must act together in the, during the elevation or during the depression, during the adduction, abduction. All the both eye muscle must act together. Hence, these muscles are called yoke muscles. Now, we'll see about the origin of this muscle. This origin of the muscles. See here, I will tell you the origin of the muscle. It is the orbital surface. Orbital surface, it is a common tendinous ring. Common tendinous ring of Jin. It is the orbital surface. It is the orbit. The orbital surface is covered, encircled.
orbital surface is covered or encircled by a common tendinous ring of ring. It is also called common tendinous ring of Jin. Here the medial rectus medially, all the rectus muscles are originate from this common tendinous ring, the common origin, medial rectus. And lateral rectus is the long muscles. Among the four rectus, longest, this adductor, this lateral rectus has one more origin. It has got the additional origin. Additional tendinous ring is here. Hence the adductor muscle, that is the lateral rectus muscle. Lateral rectus muscle has the one more additional ring. One more additional ring is here. And medial rectus, superior rectus, inferior rectus, all the four muscles have a common origin, that is the common tendinous ring of Jin. And there is the superior, then there is the levator palpebrae superioris. Levator palpebrae superioris is attached to the lesser wing of the spinoid. Lesser wing of the spinoid, that is the levator palpebrae superioris. And there is the superior rectus. Superior rectus also present here. Superior rectus present in the body of the spinoid. And there is a, superior oblique muscle. Superior oblique muscle. Superior oblique muscle. See here. It is the superior oblique muscle. Arise from the body of the spinoid. Body of the spinoid. Levator palpebrae superioris from the lesser wing of the spinoid. From the orbital surface, lesser wing of the spinoid. Superior oblique from the body of the spinoid. Whereas inferior oblique. Inferior oblique from the maxillary surface of orbital surface of the maxilla. Here there is the inferior oblique muscle is present here in the maxillary part. Superior oblique from the body of the spinoid. Inferior oblique from the maxillary part. And these muscles will have a common origin. Once again I repeat. The lesser, levator palpebrae superioris arise from the lesser wing of the spinoid. And it is very much close to the orbit. It is very much close to the orbit as well as the eyeball. And it is the highest. And it has got one more muscle. What I told you in the beginning. Involuntary muscle, the Muller muscle is there. In superior tarsus muscle. It helps in the elevation. If this nerve is paralyzed, if this muscle is paralyzed, it causes ptosis. Ptosis you might have seen in the Horner syndrome. In the Horner syndrome, the levator palpebrae superioris muscle is here. If it is very much close to the orbit, close to the eyeball, and it is the highest muscle present very much close to the eyeball. If it is paralyzed, there is a ptosis occur. There may be drooping of the eyelid. That is the ptosis occur. You might have seen in the Horner syndrome. These are all muscles and the abduction. These muscles are here. Now the superior, now insertion. The insertion is also very much peculiar. The superior rectus, middle rectus, lateral rectus, they insert on the sclera. Insert on the sclera, that is posterior to the limbus. Insert on the sclera, posterior to the limbus. Limbus is the junction between the, which separates the transparent cornea and apex sclera. Limbus. Here is the limbus present here. Just posterior to the limbus. These all four muscles insert on the sclera. Just posterior to the limbus. Limbus is the junction. Limbus is a demarcation between the cornea, transparent cornea and apex sclera, limbus. Limbus you might be knowing is the limbus is a part which is, there's a quite common in the epithelial neoplasm. Epithelial neoplasm quite common in the limbus. And the limbus is the place where the incision is taken for the cataract and the glaucoma. Three clinical significance of the limbus can be seen here. One is the epithelial neoplasm. Epithelial neoplasm is quite common here. Then there is an incision during the cataract in the